Welcome to Morning Manna with Pastor Steve Myrie. Today's topic, stay on the battlefield. And it came to pass after the year was expired, at the time when the kings would go to battle, that David sent Joab and his servants with him and all Israel, and they destroyed the children of Ammon and besieged Rabbah. But David tarried still at Jerusalem. 2 Samuel 11, verse 1. David didn't get into trouble until he left the battlefield. When he stopped fighting, he suffered his greatest defeat. Your protection depends on being in the right place. Stay at your post. Don't give the enemy an inch, or he'll take a mile. Keep your sword drawn and your shield high. Of all the armor that Paul speaks of in Ephesians 6, there is none for your back. If you think fighting is tough, wait till you see what happens when you stop fighting. We read he saw a woman washing herself, and the woman was very beautiful to look upon. Even though she was someone else's wife, David knew the consequence. He sent messengers and took her, and she came in unto him, and he lay with her. Before it was over, he committed murder in a vain attempt to cover up his sin. A baby was born and died. David's name was dragged through the mud. And saddest of all, there was given great occasions to the enemies of the Lord to blaspheme him. You need a goal so noble and a cause so great that you wouldn't dream of endangering it by laying down your sword and leaving the battlefield. The thought of the day, child of God, stay on the battlefield. It's the only safe place to be. God bless you today, in Jesus' name.
Please remember to like and subscribe to my page on YouTube. Your support is much appreciated.
Hey, Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness.